Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, I'm going to help you with the information about how do you make the pitch of your idea or your product in a hackathon or for funding. I've got experience in doing this, hence I feel that my inputs would really help you in getting some idea about how do we do it. Pitching is an art. I tell you, seriously, it is an art. You need a lot of practice, and I hope this session will give you a lot of insights on that. Pitching needs experience and practice. Pitching should be sharp and precise. Pitching should be well planned. Pitching is the face of your product. Remember all these points. Once you are okay with understanding what is a pitch, you will be all ready to learn how to pitch. Pitch is the place where you explain your product to the set of audience, to the set of judges, to the investors, so precisely, so quickly, in the best way possible to get the funding or to win the prize. You are having very limited time, but you need to explain why you should be awarded, why you should get funding. All these things are to happen within a very short, specified amount of time frame. The pitching, whatever we are going to do, can be for contest, can be for funding agencies, but the ground rule remains the same. Sir, how would I pitch, sir? I have never pitched in the past. You have never pitched, but you have heard a lot of pitches every day. You are hearing a lot of pitches every day, right from your childhood. You have seen the advertisements, right? That's the best pitch I can refer you immediately. In 30 seconds, they make you see the product. They make you feel the product. They make you buy the product. That is the effective pitching that you need to learn about. Now, there are some fundamentals that you need to remember before you go for any sort of pitching. First point, you be clear in what are you trying to present. You cannot be confused. You cannot have so many different things to be conveyed in one particular amount of time. You can convey only very limited, precise, concise thing that is going to represent your product very nicely. The pitch is going to get the investors totally attracted towards your product, and you are going to face the investors as in you are going to sell your product. That's actually selling. You are going to sell the product before even you make the product, or you just have proof of concept in the hand and you are going to get invested by the investors for your product. So you need to know what are you talking about. You cannot drag talk there. You need to have a very concise preparation done for it. And most important thing is the time. The time you got to impress them is very, very minimal. You got to sell your product within the time frame. And the judges or investors look for quick explanation. They will look about, can you present your product or idea in about 5 minutes? If you have that level of clarity, there is a real chance to get the fund. And most important thing, what is the return of investment that they will get, you will get, and you need to very clearly be aware of what is your product all about, does it have a market, and what is the return on investment. And without having a clear talk about or clear view about your profit margin, I don't think you guys will be able to get the fund or win the prize. You need to know what is your profit. And I have seen it in a lot of hackathons or pitches or funding for funding. If you say that I'm going to do it for the society, I don't want any money, that won't go well. Because you need money for running the organization, and you need to very clearly specify what is the plan for profit. Without plan for profit, without knowing what is your profit margin, I don't think your pitch will be respected properly. And most important point, apart from technical expertise and technical clarity about the presentation, about the product, you need to also know about the milestones and the schedule. You need to have a plan for next few years, in fact, and in case you want funding, you need to know how much fund do you need really for the next 1 year, 24 months, 36 months, and what are the milestones, what are the targets that you have for that funding, and how do you actually keep yourself planned for the next few years is pretty much important for you to get the funding. If you do not know what is the funding requirement, if you do not know what you want to do with the fund that you are asking for, if you do not know how do you invest it in the next 36 months, you will not get the fund. So the figures should be against the stages of the product release, and the product should grow in that time frame. And if not a perfect figure, at least you need to have a figure that tells about what is your vision with the fund that you are going to get from them. And if it is a hackathon, just tell them that I have got a proof of concept, and this proof of concept will go to a product and I'll start pitching. You need to show them the interest about you making this proof of concept to a product, without which it will be tough for you to win their hearts and to win the contest. and most important point, where your product belongs to which sector your product belongs to, should be very important, because the investors will look really into, will this product fit in into the market requirements? Will this product get attracted by the buyers? That should be going clear. And please be very clear about which segment you are talking about, which segment of customers you are talking about to sell your product. And please, most importantly, for the hackathons or the contest, the product idea, whatever you are building, should be aligned with the company's interest and goals. If a company is interested in IoT, you should make a product which has got some IoT content to it. If the company is not at all interested in IoT, and if you are projecting an IoT product to them, how much ever fascinating it is, the understanding of the product may go little lesser in that case. So the presentation should be up to the mark, and it should be aligned with the goals and the ambitions of the company, and they should be ready to invest on your product. That's very important. Now, I'm going to say you a few very important points that I have learned over a period of time, and this will help you in probably curating your pitch better. First point, have a demo ready, which means proof of concept. Make the assumptions very clear. Every product will have certain assumptions when you are building it. You need to tell that I am targeting at only this customer side. I am assuming that the customers will have preliminary knowledge of what is this product. There should be some assumptions, and you need to make it very clear. Know the plus minus of your product. Why this product? Why to invest? What is the difference that you bring? Why should the customer buy your product? All these questions will come from the judges or investors. You should have an answer well before time for all these, and that will really help you winning the prizes or winning the investment. You can project, but you can't lie or give false promises. They are all smart people, and they are seeing a lot of projects or proposals every day. So please do not lie. You can say that I project it at this level, but you cannot lie. You cannot give fake promises. And you are a businessman when you pitch, and make sure that you behave like that. Very simple. And for contest also, the same rule apply. They see you as a future businessman. You cannot lie. Don't lie at all. Don't project something which is falsified a promise. So you need to keep the precise, very clear, and whatever you have done should be projected. And whatever you want to do can be conveyed as, this is the futuristic view of what I'm going to do, but it should not be too imaginary as well. So I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. And very important point, when you go into a pitch, you keep three versions ready at least. 3 minutes, 5 minutes, or 10 minutes pitch, because we never know how much time the investors got for you, how much time the judges got for you. Unless you go there, you will not be really able to find out what is the timeline that you have in front of you. So please keep three versions ready and get yourself prepared with all the points, ready for 3, 5, or 10 minutes pitch. And know your audience before you start your pitch. Without knowing the audience, without knowing the investors, if you pitch, it's not going to work. And the next point, understand the need for the product very clearly. Why? That's the question that we need to ask yourself before you pitch. The investors are judges. They do not really care about promises. I have seen this a lot of time. They look for results. Highlight the probable results. If you have a POC, I mean the proof of concept, that's the best way you can impress your investor. And make sure that your POC works, and POC can represent your product, if not as a full, at least 80%. Whatever you want to give, the core idea should be reflected through your POC. And you need to also show that what are the features which are going to differentiate your product from the other products which are already available in the market. Highlight the challenges that the users are currently facing with the products available in the market, which you are trying to sort out. And most importantly, you should also know that who are your competitors. I mean, who are already into that market, who are already selling the product, and how are you going to disrupt that market to get your product into the market, as well as to get the customers, to reach the customers. And if it is a contest, you should have a stat which says that this is what is the problem that I'm facing right now, and this is how I need to solve it out, and this is a proof of concept that will help you in understanding how did I solve it. So it's very important. And make sure that you know, just know how. Plus, you do not just know about the know-how, you should know also know why. This statement is very clear, and most of the investors expect you to know-how and know why, without which I think it will be difficult. And the very important point, make the presentation very clear. We call it pitch deck. The pitch should talk for you. Slide should be made with utmost care. Avoid errors, avoid grammatical errors, have punctuations properly, make the slides more pictorious, which means, in fact, it should talk for you. You should avoid talking as much as you can, and it should be talking for you. It should have the stats, you should have the pictures, and make sure that you have a professional template as well. You can have a standard logo for your team or a company which you have already registered or already framed, and you can have a standard template as well, which should look extremely professional. Avoid clumsy templates. This also is looked into when you are going for a contest or pitches. And when you make a product, whom are you making it for? We are making it for customers. Who is your customer? Should be the common public or specified sector of the common public. Get their opinion and make it a quick video or make it a quick presentation. Combine all those points that are given by the customers who are facing it, and you can record it, in fact, to say that, yeah, there is a need for this product. And that will really be very helpful, even if you have a short video about customers saying that, yeah, this is the problem I'm facing. If it had been corrected like this, it would have been nice kind of stuff. If you really make it, it's going to be very helpful. And yeah, how do you make the PPT? That's very, very important. So how do you make the pitch is the next point, is the point that I have covered all this time. Now, how do you make the presentation is also equally important. Remember this point. Have a problem, have a solution, highlight the market. Mention and highlight why are you unique. The pitch should have the problem statement very clearly. And why now should be there. This problem has been there in the market so long, and why are you now talking about it so high? That has to be highlighted. Product architecture and functioning of it. How does it work? Quickly, it need not be so technical. Again, understand, the people who sit there are mostly people who are into business, and they might not look into the technicalities of how the product works, but still, they would like to know. But you need not go much deeper into the level of architectural details of each and every module. It can be a fundamental overall architecture which will help them understand how the product works. Next point, key value. How is your product special? That should be there. Who are your competitors? Mention their name, tell their weakness. Market. What is the market for it? Sir, how do we analyze it, sir? There are a lot of websites like Market and Market where you can go and see what is the projection of this particular project. How does exactly the market, how is exactly the market going to accept this product? Are all projected very clearly already in many websites, many business websites which you can refer and cite them as well in the paper. Marketing plan. How do you plan to market your product? What is your strategy? How are you planning to scale it up? How are you planning to project it to the market? All these are very important. And business model. What is your business model? That's very, very important. I'll probably give you a session on how to frame a business model in near future. Milestones and schedule. How do you plan your product release? What are the milestones that you have in your mind? How do you plan to complete your product within the time that the investors expect to complete your product? All these things are very important. And what are your plans for funding? You are pitching now. You must have got some funding and you may want some more funding. So how do you plan to meet the requirements of financial necessities for you to build the product? And testimonials. There could be some users who have tested your POC. There could be some feedback that you have got from previous investors meet. Something should be there as feedback. So mention it and highlight it. And finally, the team. There should be a team for you, as I normally say, team wins, and know clearly your responsibilities. Mention that this guy is going to take care of business, this guy is going to take care of the software and hardware architecture. Likewise, you need to highlight your team strength there. I hope I have given you a quick, concise, precise, clear note about how do you ready the pitch deck and how do you pitch it. If you have any clarification, any questions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to answer your queries. Thank you very much for supporting my channel. I see that it's growing quite consistently. And if you have any specific requirements, please go ahead and type it. Once again, thank you. Wish you all a very happy New Year, folks. Thank you very much.